This video demonstrates how to use the AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery, Mass Failback Automation Client, or DRSFA, to automate the failback of multiple recovery instances to the source VMware environment. For this demo, we have three virtual machines, which are located in our on-premises VMware environment. These are the original source servers that were replicated with AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery and then recovered on AWS during a disaster event. You can see these three recovered servers now running natively on the Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud, or EC2 console. We will be using the DRSFA client to automate the failback steps to recover back to the source VMware environment. First, we need to create a VMware user in the source VMware environment, which the DRSFA client uses to automate the VMware actions required for failback. In this example, we have a user called DRSFA user with the permissions shown on the screen, assigned via role assignment. You can get more information about the required permissions by visiting the AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery documentation.
We have downloaded the latest AWS DRS Failback client and uploaded it to the VMware data store. The download URL is shown on screen. You should modify specifying the correct region for your use case.
As per the documentation, we have deployed an Ubuntu server within our source VMware environment. This is where we will install, configure, and run the DRSFA client. This server must run Python 3.9.4 with pip installed. Other versions of Python will not work. Now that we've handled the prerequisites, we're ready to download the DRSFA client. Install it using the supplied shell script. If prompted, enter the sudo password. Once the installation is complete, we need to create a password that is used to authenticate with the VMs running the DRS Failback client. Run the following command to generate the seed.iso file. When prompted, enter a secure password. Upload the generated ISO file to the same data store as the DRS Failback client is stored. Now that we have completed the initial installation, we need to generate the required AWS credentials and then run the DRSFA client. Navigate to the AWS Management Console and search for IAM, under Find Services. Select Users, from the left-hand navigation menu, then select Add Users. Give the user a username, then select Programmatic Access. Next, choose the Attach Existing Policies option, search for and select the AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery Failback Policy. Add any tags you require, then select Create User. Take note of, or download the access and secret keys because we will need these later in the process. Once the user is created, we need to add additional inline policies to allow the user to use the generated credentials. Select the newly created user. Add an inline policy. Select DRS as the service. Then select Describe Source Servers as the action. Give the inline policy a name, then create the policy. Add a second inline policy. Select STS under Service. Then select Get Caller Identity as the action. Give the inline policy a name, then create the policy. To allow the DRSFA client logs to be sent to Amazon CloudWatch, create a CloudWatch log group called DRS Mass Failback Automation. If this log group is not created or if it's created with the wrong name, the DRSFA client will still work, but logs will not be sent to CloudWatch.
When you run the DRSFA client, a number of parameters must be provided, such as the vCenter configuration information and the AWS credentials that we previously generated. Here you can see an example run command. Now we will run the DRSFA client, passing the parameters that are unique to our environment.
From the DRSFA client menu, select one-click failback. Enter a custom prefix for the results output, so it will be easier for you to find it later. Enter yes to continue. The failback replication process has now been initiated for the three recovery instances. We can see within the vCenter environment that the source VMs have been powered off, the failback client and seed.iso has been attached, and the VMs have been powered back on. Once this process is complete, the failback client will pair with the corresponding recovery instance in AWS, and replication will be reversed. Replication back to the on-premises source servers is initiated from the source server, toward the recovery instance. Only the delta changes are replicated back to the source servers. The DRSFA client will report the status on screen, and to a JSON output file. Here we can see that the process was successful. Monitor the failback progress on the recovery instances page in the DRS console. After the recovery instances show healthy status under the data replication status column, and ready status under the failback state column, we are able to failback to our vCenter environment, and then finalize the failback process. Select the checkbox to the left of each instance ID and choose failback. On the Continue with Failback dialog, choose failback. Data replication back to the source server will be stopped and the conversion process will be started. This will finalize the failback process and will create a replica of each recovery instance on the corresponding source server. Once the failback is complete, the failback client will show that the failback has been completed successfully. You can opt to either terminate, delete, or disconnect the recovery instances.
Visit the AWS DRS product page to learn more and get started.